Good morning, everyone. My name is Justyna Skibińska, and together with my supervisor, Associate Professor Radim Burgat from Brno University of Technology, have made the research about Parkinson's disease detection based on changes of emotion during speech. Let me first start to talk about the agenda of the presentation. So first of all, I will describe the motivation which stays behind the carry out experiment. Then I will describe the evaluation of the work. It will include the flow of the algorithm, the steps about data preprocessing, including future extraction and machine learning approaches used in this work. Then I will describe the results of the prediction, likewise the interpretability of the created model thanks to the usage of sharp values. Finally, I will summarize the work. On this slide, I will talk about the motivation of the research. So one of the main problems that society will face within 30 years is the population aging phenomena. The occurrence of neurodegenerative diseases is connected with the old age, and one of them is Parkinson's disease. When Parkinson treatment is administered in the early stage, the impairment of health is significantly smaller thanks to the applied treatment. This is the reason why early detection of this disease is highly demanded. However, it's not an easy task to objectively measure the progress of brain disease. The evaluation of this disease used in clinical practice is based on the so-called Unified Parkinson Disease Rating Scale. However, it's quite subjective and no automatized method. This is the reason why there is a need to create an objective methodology, and that one which could be cheaper than imaging technology like MRI, CT, etc. Additionally, the technology based on mHealth or eHealth could serve as great solutions for measuring progress or controlling themselves in patient home instead of going to the hospital, which will be highly appreciated by the patients, their family and clinicians. Now I will go to the description of the evaluation of the experiment. The main goal of this experiment has been to evaluate the accuracy of Parkinson's disease detection based on changes in the expression of emotion during the speech. In particular, in physiognomic changes during exercises. It is during reading selected text by BD patients and healthy control, or saying difficult to pronounce tongue twister. The assumption of this work was dictated by the statement that the expression of emotion by PD is disturbed. They manifest the stiffness of the facial muscle. Likewise, PD patient has a problem with the correct articulation. They manifest so-called hypomimia. Nonetheless, the choice of tongue twister allowed us to minimize the influence of the subjectiveness of expression emotion on the evaluation of the disease. It is supposed to monitor the impaired ability of expressing emotion under more natural conditions. The language used in this experiment was Czech, and the number of the participants involved in the experiment was 115, 70 PD patients and 45 healthy control. In a nutshell, the collected data set was used for training machine learning methodology to create support decision methodology. This shows the bottom diagram. The upper diagram represents the more detailed explanation of the carry-out experiment. For the detection of the level of expressing CD emotion on each frame, it was used publicly available model of facial emotion recognition trained on the publicly available dataset FIR 2013. This algorithm contains two steps. It has multitask cascade convolutional networks, and this is visible on the first block on the diagram, and architecture for computing the intensity of emotion, the second block on diagram. The scales value prepared for the training were computed from the time series represent the record of changing each emotion during speech task. Next, the machine learning algorithms were used to finally obtain the model indicate the prediction of the disease. On this slide, I will present to you the results of the usage of facial emotion recognition software. On the left side, you can see the detected face together with the intensity of six emotions representing numbers. Due to privacy issue, the face of PD patient was blurred. Whereas, in the second picture, you can observe the record of changes in expressing emotion during pronunciation the tongue twister. Cały wieczór se usis czytać. This means in English, he's been learning to count all night. The time course represents a different emotion in the chart. Slides show extension of the flow of the algorithm in the used machine learning methodology. Once again, I will repeat the steps connected to emotion extraction, that's calculation of intensity of emotion on each frame thanks to the neural networks, There were exactly happiness, sadness, fear, surprise, neutrality, anger, and disgust. In the next step, there were computed such scalar parameters as standard deviation, relative standard deviation, variance, mean, minimum, maximum, range, slope, and futures computed based on the distribution of data, it is kurtosis and skewness. Furthermore, other more indicators describing the measure of information disorder were taken into consideration. There were approximate entropy, dedicated to medical series, and Shannon entropy. This set of features was calculated for all of the types of records of emotion. Subsequently, it was used future preselection algorithm, so-called maximum relevance, minimum redundancy, to decrease the number of the futures used for training. Then, it was used classification with certified cross-validation and selection classifier, about which I will talk on the next slides. Finally, there were obtained results with prediction. The results of the two carried out experiments are presented in two tables. The left table represents the results of model prediction, which was trained off the data of tongue twister. Six algorithms were chosen for this purpose. For each of them, the parameters were optimized and the balance accuracy, sensitivity, specificity, and Matthews correlation coefficients were computed. The most accurate solution that allows us to detect Parkinson's disease has been identified as XGBoost classifier, according to balance accuracy. The accuracy balance succeeded in 6900. Matthews correlation coefficient was also the highest for this algorithm and was equal to 5900. The sensitivity and specificity were 7100 and 67 respectively. The highest sensitivity was achieved for logistic regression, 7300, and specificity 7300 was achieved for decision tree. The results of the prediction was compared with the speech exercise, reading long text with the usage of XGBoost. The results are shown in the right table. The tongue twister achieved 7900 accuracy balance, and for the long text it was 6000 accuracy balance. The rest of the metrics were also better in the case of tongue twister. The use of XGBoost was dictated by the fact that in many publications from recent years, the best result for structured data was achieved by using this classifier. This classifier is taking into consideration L1 and L2 regularization, likewise penalization of the number of leaf nodes. Those regularization methodologies are not found in other tree algorithms or other classifier used in this work. The interpretability of the model was explained with the use of SHAB values and is presented on this graph. The most important features according to explainability in the descending order are standard deviation of fear, approximate entropy of surprise, variance of fear, maximum of anger, range of fear, variance of anger, maximum of fear, mean of surprise, mean of fear, and approximate entropy of sadness. The standard deviation of fear, variance of fear, maximum of anger, variance of anger, maximum of fear, and mean of fear are positively correlated with the prediction of Parkinson's disease. However, the approximate entropy of surprise, approximate entropy of sadness are negatively correlated with Parkinson's disease. To summarize and conclude, the changes in fear were correlated the best by features like standard deviation, variance, range, or mean. It could mean that this kind of emotion is recognized during the speech exercise as difficulty which meets the PD patients, making them uncertain level actions in comparison to healthy control. Moreover, the approximate entropy of sadness and surprise is negatively correlated with Parkinson's disease. This fact could indicate lower changes in the expression of these emotions for PD patients. To summarize, it was created the automatic system for the detection of Parkinson's disease. According to our knowledge, there exists limited number of work which are dealing with recognizing PD based on hypomimia symptom. However, the use assumption in the works are making the created so far decision support methodology as quite subjective. Our work allows to minimize this influence. We have checked which kind of future are the most valuable according to the prediction of the model. This model for detection PD based on speech exercise, a tongue twister, and trained with the XGBoost has interpretability and clinical understanding. Additionally, it was shown the difference expressing the emotion of PD patients versus healthy control during pronunciation tongue twister. The higher level of fear and sadness were registered for PD patients. Next, the best results in those cases were obtained thanks to the usage of XGBoost classifier. Considering which metrics were the most valuable, there were standard deviation, variance, range and mean. In terms of future direction, it could be beneficial to test other tongue twister and extend the database to obtain better results. To obtain both results after applying step of future direction could be potentially used as a mHealth solution, however, it's the first work with this kind of the approach. I would like to thank you to our project. This project has received funding from the European Union's Horizon 2020, Marie Skłodowska-Curie Innovation Training Networks. Thank you for your attention.